Hello everybody, my name is Zohri Chaudhary and today we'll talk about sources of greenhouse gases. In order to understand the sources of greenhouse gases, it's extremely important to understand what combustion is. So combustion is essentially when we burn fuel, and fuel can be anything that has carbon, hydrogen, and oxygen that contains energy, such as coal, natural gas, petroleum oil, gasoline, fuel oil, wood, or anything that is made up of these organic chemicals. So CHO, carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, also known in this combination, also known as fuel, when it's burnt in the presence of oxygen, it releases carbon dioxide and water vapor, as well as heat energy. This heat energy is what we utilize, and the byproduct of combustion is carbon dioxide and water vapor gases that are released into the air. As you remember from the other lecture, carbon dioxide and water vapor, they are greenhouse gases. They have greenhouse gas properties. So by burning fossil fuel or by burning fuel, we release greenhouse gases such as carbon dioxide and water vapor. So which countries produce more greenhouse gases? From very, very long, it has always been the United States of America that produced the most greenhouse gases. It used to produce about one third of the greenhouse gases for a very, very long time. But over the last 15, 20 years, China has progressed tremendously because of industrialization and many other things that have been happening in China. And for the last, I think, 6, 7, or 8 years, China has overtaken the US, and China right now produces almost about one third of the global greenhouse gas emissions. And US right now is a second. And here are the various industry that produce greenhouse gases. So what are the major greenhouse gases and their sources? So CO2, methane, and nitrous oxide, these are three major greenhouse gases that you'll hear over and over again. Each of these, they have a natural source and an anthropogenic source. For example, for carbon dioxide, the natural source is respiration. All living organisms, we respire and we give off carbon dioxide. Decomposition also produces carbon dioxide. These are natural sources of greenhouse gases. On the other hand, burning of fossil fuel produces a lot of greenhouse gases. About 65% of all greenhouse gases are from fossil fuel burning. Deforestation also removes the plants they can absorb the greenhouse gases such as carbon dioxide because of the photosynthesis that plants do. And burning of rainforest, on the other hand, produces more greenhouse gases such as CO2. Land use conversion also removes the greenhouse gases, produces greenhouse gases because you are converting, let's say, a forest areas into a city or grassland into a city, and as a result you are removing the sink of CO2. Over time, right now, the anthropogenic sources of greenhouse gases produce a lot more greenhouse gases than the natural sources. The next greenhouse gas is methane, and methane is produced naturally from microbial activity in the absence of oxygen, so anaerobic microbial activity, as well as in wetlands and other sources in bogs. On the other hand, anthropogenic sources of methane are coming from agriculture or animal husbandry, especially like when you're producing rice paddy, it requires water to be in the roots of the rice, which, because it produces an anaerobic environment in the root, releases a lot of methane from rice cultivation, as well as cattle release a lot of methane as well. Drilling for oil, landfilling, biomass burning, all of this also produces methane as we do this more and more and more. In fact, anthropogenic sources for methane accounts for 70% of methane produced annually all over the globe. The last one that we'll talk today is nitrous oxide. It is produced from microbial activity in the soil. On the other hand, anthropogenic sources are from fertilizer use as well as from transportation. Fertilizer, remember, nitrogen is used as a fertilizer. So nitrous oxide comes out when you use fertilizer for agriculture. So carbon dioxide, methane, and nitrous oxide, they all have natural sources as well as anthropogenic sources And with time, right now, anthropogenic sources are becoming extremely important, and they've actually overtaken the amount of these gases that are produced naturally. And because of this, we are seeing this enhanced greenhouse gas effect that I talked earlier. Let's do a quick concept check. Which of the two countries produce nearly half of the world's greenhouse gases? Exactly, A, India, and sorry, US and China, C. US and China, C. Thank you.